Welcome once again to Grim 3D. Today, I am going to let you in on a little repair process. I've actually done this before, but I thought you guys might want to see it done. I'm going to replace the bearings on the bed of the Monoprice Maker Select Plus. Stay tuned. So here's the bed of my Maker Select Plus. I've noticed when this bed moves back and forth under the power of the stepper motor, I hear kind of a clacking noise. Okay, so I wiggled my bed around a little bit and I noticed, I don't know if you can see this, I noticed where it was coming from. Let me zoom in there a little bit. So once I've zoomed in, you notice when I lift this up and down, it moves quite a bit. Maybe I can get a microphone in there closer. You can also hear it. So then I was actually able to take a gander underneath there. And this may show up on the camera well, it may not. But if I move this up and down, you can actually see that bearing is loose on that guide rod. It actually kind of looks like the guide rod is moving, but it really isn't moving all that much. It's just the reflections off of it. So I'm gonna go ahead and replace that bearing, and I think I'm gonna take this back to a four bearing setup instead of a three bearing setup. So let's get going. So I pulled the Maker Select over and I put it on my desk here where I'm going to work on it. First thing I'm going to do is I'm going to remove the heated bed so I can get down to the carriage plate that's got the bearings in it. Just putting a little pressure on the heat plate down towards the carriage and going to just take out these thumb screws. Take my heated bed. Carefully pick it up. Now, for anybody who hasn't seen my other videos, the bottom of this heat plate is very fragile. You want to make sure you don't scratch it on anything. You can actually damage the wires that make your printer heat up just by letting it scrub on something. So I'm going to put it upside down here. I think that'll probably be good for now. Move my springs off of there. Okay, and then the next thing I need to do is loosen up this guide rod. Now I should be able to lift this up fairly easily and slide this front support off. Going to go ahead and loosen up my bearing carriage, or sometimes they call these bearing blocks. I've heard them called that quite a bit. So maybe carriage isn't the right name for it. And while I'm in here, I probably could replace all the bearings, but I don't really want to because these bearings are fairly new and I think this one was just bad, or maybe my three bearing setup put a little bit too much stress on it. So I'm gonna pull this bearing out of there. So this bearing block right here is actually plastic on the Monoprice Maker Select Plus, and it just holds bearing inside friction style. There's no on these larger bearings that I replaced quite a while ago. I went from smaller bearings that did have spring clips holding them in here, but I changed it for the longer bearings for a little bit extra leverage on the bearings. And these hold inside the plastic bearing blocks, friction only. So here I have both of these bearing blocks with bearings in it. These bearings are going to be thrown away. I'm going to take these out of here just with a little pliers force. And then I'm going to grab it, pull it straight out of there. That can go in the garbage later. Same thing here. I'm going to force it out. Grab it with my pliers. Pull it out. Remove. This is the bearing block that I removed when I went to the three bearing setup. And if you look at that video, I'll put the link in the description, although you probably don't need it because you're at my channel already. But I will link to that video where I went to the three bearing setup and said right in the video pretty much that I didn't know if it was going to work. And so if I didn't like it, I was going to go back with the four bearing setup. And I think blowing out a bearing or ruining a bearing in a few weeks is a pretty good indicator that it's not working well. It may make it quieter. You may only need three contact points to create a plane, but I think that four bearings is better than three. So far, it's showing to me that four bearings is better than three. So next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to take these bearings. I'm going to put them back in these blocks, which should be about as easy as getting them out. If you need to, you can use a flat blade to wedge open this slit here. I haven't found that to be the case, though, and these bearings on the right-hand side, you kind of just want them to be as centered as possible. On the left-hand side, there is an issue where the one in the rear, if it is centered, it hits the Y-axis limit switch too quickly. And so you actually have to put that one off-centered, but you still can use the long bearings in here, either way, on all four of the bearing blocks. I've been doing it for probably a year now. Center that up. I want to make sure that I've got a bearings inside in the race on the top and the bottom of the bearing block so that as gravity pulls the plate down, it will put pressure directly on bearings and not on any of the plastic interior of this bearing. I did get these linear bearings off Amazon. If I can find the order, which I probably can, I'll put the link down in the description so you can have it. Well, here we go. It's time to put it back together. That was pretty easy, huh? One thing I like to do with these bearings before I put them on, which you can print out a device to help you with this, but I don't know that I've noticed it's needed. I like to use some of this super lube, synthetic grease, and I like to just put some in there. I'm going to put it in on the side. Guide rod's going to go in. Just put some in there. And I'm going to put some in here. Just kind of to pre-lube these bearings. The guide rod will push it around, should get it in there. It's going to push a little bit out the back side, which is not a big deal. You just wipe that off on your rag there. We'll move that one in kind of to where it goes. Then we're going to put this one on with the grease going on first. Get it on there. Feels nice. A little pressure on that grease, force it into the bearings a little bit. There we go. That one kind of where it goes. Wipe my hands off. And now I'm going to go ahead and put these guide rod holders back in place. think these guide rod holders are pretty good at squaring these guide rods up. Remember, I didn't loosen the one back there. But you just have to be careful to put them back together in the right order. I'm going to try to get these long screws that I put in my slanted LCD. I'm going to go ahead and put those in, but not tight. I never tighten screws the first time around, especially when there's multiples that have to go in. Put this one back in. Then I'm going to put these little ones in. These ones are kind of cool because if they're with the tapered head, they actually help to index these guide rods properly, which is kind of nice. Now I'm going to go ahead and tighten these down. These bigger ones. Part of the LCD enclosure. And then tighten these down. So now that I've got these guide rod holders in place, I'm going to put in these set screws carefully. Guide rods are fairly solid. I am going to work on the screws that hold in my bearing blocks that I just installed. There are 8 screws. And I'm going to do the same thing with them. I'm going to put them in, but not tighten them down until I get them all in. Pretty much a theme. Start tightening the screws down. Invariably, the last one won't go in. And then you have to loosen a bunch of them back up to get the last one in. And you've just wasted a ton of time. Now they're all in. I'm going to go ahead and tighten them down a little bit more. And then I'm going to do one more time around, just checking them to make sure they're all about the same amount of tightness. And then I can go ahead and very carefully flip my heat bed back over. Once again, being very, very careful with the bottom of it that has wires embedded on it that are easily scratched and will stop your heat bed from heating up if they are scratched. That has happened to me in the past. There's 2 springs, 3 springs. Four springs. So once I've got the springs in place, then I can go ahead and put the thumb screws back on. I'm gonna have to level the bed anyways, obviously, so I'm just gonna go ahead and put them all on nice and tight, so when I go to start leveling the bed, I won't run my hot end into the bed and ruin my flexible magnetic setup I got here. A quick check. Wow, that feels better already. A little up and down motion. Don't have any slop, no noises, no clacking, nothing. I'm gonna call that a job well done. Thanks for joining us once again here on Grim 3D. As always, if you like the video, please subscribe. Smash that like button, click the bell. We'll see you out there.